followed by two words, either believe in or believe on. And I said to, and I explained to you, I said to believe in is to hold as an object of faith. Which means as a Christian, you must be able to have something you are holding on to. Don't walk through this year without having an object in your face. In order for you to be settled, you have to have an object you are holding on to. Say, neighbor, what are you holding on to? And then I told you in John 1 verse 12, in John 14 verse 1, it says, you believe in God, believe also in me. Jesus was saying to them, if you believe in God, believe also in me. Hold on to me. Hold on to me. I am your object. Say, neighbor, what are you holding on to this year? And the second part, which I'm going today, it says, to believe on is to trust. And our second point is trust God without wavering. It says to believe means to believe on is to trust, to place a full confidence, to rest upon with faith. In John 1 verse 12, the Bible says, to them he gave power. Everybody say power. To become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name. To believe on is to trust. So we say, point number two, in order for God to settle you this year, you have to trust him without wavering. Now understand, one of the biggest problems today in the world hindering people from being settled is the issue of trust. Oh, come on, talk to me somewhere tonight. There are many of you today who are not married yet. It's the issue of trust. Somebody talk to me right now. These days, it's hard to trust people. Somebody can be really talking good to you right now, and behind you, they are destroying you. So the issue, it's about trust. You can't even trust your father. You can't even trust your mother. You can't even trust your government. Right now in the parliament, there's a problem of trust. Government don't trust opposition. Opposition don't trust no government. Everybody has some level of reservation. As I began to ponder upon this word, trust God without wavering, I discovered because what's happening in the natural, it has fitted now in the spiritual. We are so bombarded with the issue of trust that we can't trust God no more. And if God is your divine settler, you will have to trust him based upon what you know about him. Now understand this, and I said this in my office this morning, is a lot of people today, they misunderstand the word trust. Many of you have lost your goods to people you trust on credit. You see, the word trust has to be the father. I believe in this person. I know the capacity of this person. I know what that person can do. Going somewhere with this. And so what is happening today is a lot of people today, we have lost our direction because we trusted the wrong people. Am I talking to someone tonight? And so what is happening now is that, my God, you see, people come to you, maybe you sell stuff, and they come to you to trust them, but you don't even know their address, you don't know their number, you don't even know who they are, but you see them around your neighborhood. And then somehow, after some couple of weeks, the person don't show up again. You start